The Skjøya collection holds nine fragments that were excluded from the publication of the present texts in Guinness on the case that we published in August last year. The editorial group disqualified these texts very late in the process of studying and publishing the fragments and deleted close to full-fledged text editions that have required months of preparation. And I want here to thank the editorial team, Michael, Ira, Horstein, and Kim, for we worked very closely together. We came to this conclusion from material and photographic observations, also noting the striking similarity between the text
can
in
I
these
have
fragments
one,
and modern text editions. The handout is going out. I hope I have 30 copies. The text we excluded were one Tobit, three First Enoch, three Exodus fragments, one Nehemiah, and one Samuel. A number of the new fragments display a line for line alignment with the published text edition, such as Kiddush, Biblia Hebraica, or DJD. All the inner fragments contain text remarkably close to the reconstructed Aramaic text of Millet's 1976 edition of the books of Enoch. And one of the Exodus texts seems to be written with 4Q Exodus B as solar. An interesting parallel is the Gospel of Jesus' wife Papyrus and his sister-in-law, a Coptic fragment of John's Gospel appearing 10 years ago. A comparison between these two recently appearing Coptic fragments display the same scribal hand. This is the observations of Christian Askeland. And further, if you look to the Coptic Gospel of John and compare it with this Coptic John Codex published by Herbert Thompson in 1924, Askeland has shown that the new Coptic fragment is a crude but almost exact copy of this Cow Codex published in the 20s. And there are 37 identical line breaks between these two Coptic charts. This is too good to be true. A line-for-line alignment, the published text edition, can also be observed in a number of the 30 fragments that have been acquired by four American collections in 2009. Some examples from three collections will be presented here. Most of these appeared on the market in 2009, around three already in 2003. We start with some examples from the Green Collection of the Bible, Numeri 8, 3 to 5. It is remarkable that this fragment has exactly the same letter spaces per line as Kittel's Biblia Hebraica. You see here, the first line starts here, the second line starts here, the third line starts here, and the fourth line starts here. If this happened with one fragment, it could be a random hit. But this is the case with too many fragments, so many that the phenomenon causes suspicion. The fragment further displays two textual variants found in the Kittel's apparatus, where Kittel and Leningrad leads out Pircha. This reads Ve'at Pilchecha with a number of Hebrew messages. And the latter word is also written with a longer spelling, indicated pluralis, as the Samaritanus and the Greek. And we know in general that the green fragments, there we encounter a disproportionately high frequency of textual variants compared to the small amount of preserved texts. And over to Green Nehemiah. Also here, we are very close to the same number of letter spaces per line as in Kittel. Line 1 starts here, line 2 starts here, and line 3 starts here. And two words in line 3 are read by editors as the Ashur, the Avo, identical with the Masoretic text, but this is not possible. The Ashur, the Avo. This ink here is read by the editors as a vowel, but the surface is preserved below this ink stroke, so it cannot be the head of a vowel. But if you go to Kittel, the Ashuv, the Avo, you have a text critical sign alpha here, and you compare this alpha with this alpha here. A modern slip of the. This is Kittel's observation, it's not mine. I did not have this image at that time. So this is a modern slip of the pen that could not be erased. And, Eureka, this fragment is from the Alpha Cave. Then over to the green fragment of Daniel 10, can also be compared to Kittel. And again, we see very similar letter spacing per line as in Kittel. Line 1 supposed to start here, line 2 here, line 3 here. And we have a variant reading where M has Chazak, the Chazak, two ethical imperatives. Here we have Chazak, the Hit Chazek. He piled in the second word, a suggestion by the Schutkartensia editors based on an early suggestion by Karl Martin. And also the Greek uses two different verbs here. Then over to the green fragment of instruction, a fragment surfacing in 2004. This parchment or skin fragment is so small that it is too small to make out a fancy biblical variant. What you do with that small piece of empty parchment? Yes, you copy two verses from 40 instructions from DJD 34 with two full words and some elements of ink. We made it. We turn to another fragment. Now we go to the Azusa Pacific University, Deuteronomy 8. Again, the opening of the lines align perfectly with verse appearing below each other in six subsequent lines in Kittel. Again, two good picture. Line 1 here, line 2 here, line 3, 4, 5, 6. And also here we find interesting textual variant in its vortal. It follows the Kere, and in line 2, where the Masoretic has the Lo Yadun, we have the Lo Yadun, with the Samaritans. Then over to the Israelite Exodus, and Martin has already shown this to us. And we look to one of the fragments, Exodus 3, 13 to 15. The four lines of the fragment, they align perfectly, line for line, with the DJD publication of 4Q Exodus B. And one needs to duplicate a wakat in 4Q Exodus B to really reconstruct the text. And we have exactly the same letter spacing per line as in the relevant column of 4Q Exodus B. Again, can this be a random hit? And textually, we have a variation between El Bnei Yisrael and Lev Bnei Yisrael between these two Judean desert scrolls, a difference in the short and long spelling of Elohim, and a different location of Od, respectively before or after Elohim. Common scribal variations in the ancient time. Then over to Skoyen Nehemiah, a fragment first published on the web by Charlesworth in 2009. The script here is small, and this fragment is written to imitate 4Q Ezra. And the comparison with Kitty shows the opening verse of the four lines exactly following "Work we love each other" in Kitty. And also here you have interesting textual variants that you could work out, working from the apparatus in Kittel and Sutkartensia. We continue with Skjøen Tobit. A fragment I was proud to publish in the Revue de Cumeran in 2006 together with Michaela Hardemeyer. And now I don't think it is authentic.
Sorry.
And again,
authentic or not?
It is not authentic.
Oh.
And you could take it from 4Q Tobit C published in DJD. You also note here that the fragment is written crossing the vertical fibers. That is the not common way of writing perhaps in the ancient time. It's much more convenient to follow the horizontal fibers. There is another example from the same show. This is not published. This is still in a so-called private collection. And Deborah Demand and I became independently from each other to the same conclusion. This is the same scribal hand. And after I had my identification, not published, I found out that both are modern forgeries. And also this is written across the vertical fibers. Here over to Skjøen Enoch. This is parchment, and we go to, and again, remarkable overlap with Millick's reconstructions. Not the preserved Qumran Enoch text, but Millick their reconstructions based on the retroversion into Aramaic from a 14th to 16th century Ethiopic translation. Remember that the Ethiopic translation has passed from Aramaic to Greek to Ethiopic. So to find the reconstructions on Millick in the new fragments is remarkable. Here a papyrus, Enoch, again, we find it in Millick, line for line. And here is the last Enoch that Michael showed you. To the end, we have five papyrus fragments appearing after 2003. Representing four scrolls, if the two Tobit are the same scroll, and all four are written transverta charta, crossing the vertical fibers. I have learned from Miriam Klutz at the Berlin Papyrus Museum that not more than 10% of ancient papyri from these periods have been written transverta charta. And then all four scrolls that have appeared after 2002, they are written transverta charta. The statistical chance that four scrolls written in this uncommon way and none other scrolls written the other way would appear after 2002 is 1 out of 10,000. The scholars worked with the Skjøen fragment text, invested several months of scholarly study to make text editions of fragments that we ended up classifying as modern forgeries. Some of these have Hebrew and Aramaic textual variants that require high scholarly knowledge. Some of these fragments appeared already in 2003, while the large waves of the new fragments came around 2009. Many of the recent fragments are so ingeniously made that there must be scholars around who have struggled hard to provide interesting material both for us and motivated buyers among Bible-oriented American Christians. Thank you.